Hello everyone, in the last video we discussed about implementation phase. That is, what is the implementation and what are the various programming languages that could be used for implementing our specifications. And we discussed what were the good coding style rules that must be followed by each programmer so that their program could be in the understandable form. And the next topic that today we are going to discuss is software maintenance phase. First thing that is that we are going to discuss is, what is software maintenance? It is basically the modification of a software product after delivery to either correct the faults or to improve the performance. So basically, software maintenance is generally done after the delivery of a product it may be possible that some faults could become after the product after the software become functional, or it may be possible that we want to improve the performance of a software. So in this case, software maintenance plays an important role. So a common perception of maintenance is that it is merely involved fixing defects, but not only software maintenance is used for fixing the defects only. It could be also for improving the performance. Or it could be because we want our system to be more perfect. So maintenance is not only fixing the defects. In the later slides, we will discuss about the types of maintenance, like adaptive maintenance, corrective maintenance, etc. So it is the general process of changing a system after it has been delivered, and changes could be because of the problems that may arise in the system, or because the user wants to improve the performance. So in both cases, we could use the maintenance phase. So these are the reasons for maintaining the software. When software gets released or it becomes functional, then what are the various reasons that it is mandatory to maintain the software? What are the various reasons? First reason is, over a period of time, software original requirement may change. It may be possible that at the time when software was released, the user was satisfactory requirements were there, but it may be possible that over a period of time, customer wants to change the original requirements. So in this case, if the user or if the customer needs some changes, then the software maintenance, it comes under the software maintenance phase. After that, errors undetected during the software development phase, it may be possible that some errors remain undetected during the development phase. So in maintenance phase, the developer could remove these problems. And at last, with the time, as the new technology comes in market, so definitely customer also wants to upgrade its software. So in this case, he or she also wants to maintain their software. So mainly reasons of maintaining the software are because of customer requirement changes, because some errors could occur, or at last we can say that because during the time passes, the new technology comes in market. So if new technologies are coming in market, so definitely user wants that their software should also be accurate or according to the new technologies. So these are the various reasons for maintaining a software. Okay, if we talk about cost distribution of SDLC, then as we know that SDLC phase is required requirement analysis, design, implementation, testing, and maintenance phase. So as you can see that almost 67% of total cost is there in maintenance phase of SDLC. For other in requirement analysis, this is 83% of total cost. In designing the internal, it is on an average that what basically these phases are taking the cost. So it is generally we are taking in average cases. So requirement phase is having the 3% cost, and the designing phase is going to require 8% cost. Implementation phase is generally coding phase, in which it requires 7% of total cost. The testing requires 15% of total cost, and after the testing, the next phase that comes is the maintenance, and it requires almost 67% of total cost of the SDLC. So according to this graph, you can easily see that maintenance plays a pivot role in SDLC. You can say in developing the software, because after these phases, requirement, designing, implementation, and testing, your software is completed according to you. But as and when it goes to the user side, then what the user wants is, and what will be the various changes according to user perspective. These all changes are comes in the maintenance part. So the maintenance phase generally incur 67% cost on an average. The next is, what are the various problems that software maintenance could face? The first is, most computer programs are difficult and expensive to maintain. It is possible that some programs were developed by some other programmer, and as the time passes, if other programmer is seeing the program that is done by other programmer, so really very difficult and expensive to maintain the problem, the previous program. So the second point, that is, software changes are poorly designed and implementation. It may be possible that software changes that the user are going to give is not properly designed and implemented. Next problem that may arise is that the repair and enhancement of software often inject new bugs that must later be repaired. It may be possible that because of maintenance, we are changing in one module, but as you all know that if we are changing in one module, that may be affected to the other module. So repair and enhancement of software could also bring the new bugs that must later be repaired, and definitely it will require the extra cost to get repaired. If next is, changes are often not documented. Previously, when these SDLC, according to SDLC, when a particular software is developed, then definitely it will follow the steps like design. First of all, analysis will be done, and after that, designing, testing, implementing, and testing, and after that, maintaining phase will be done. But if some changes are there, then these changes will not be reflected in the document again. So it is the problem with software maintenance. So as and when the new programmer will come and see the documentation with respect to the program, then both could be different. So in that case, he may not be able to properly identify that basically what is the documentation and what are the various changes that are going to required in the program. And at last, changes often cause new fault in the system. As we can say that in third point, we have already discussed this point, that changes often cause new fault in the system. It may be possible that we are changing in one program, but definitely it could be the reason of new faults in the system. So these are the problems that could arise in the software maintenance during we are doing the software maintenance. Next, most important topic of this unit is types of software maintenance. There are four types of maintenance that are very important. First is corrective maintenance, as the name already describes what is the functionality of it. In corrective maintenance, basically we are fixing the bugs that could be arise or that could be detected as and when the software gets functional. The second is adaptive maintenance. Adaptive maintenance, what is adaptive? Adaptive means we are adopting the changes. Yeah, according to market, if we are doing some changes or we are migrating our software according to the environment, according to the changes technology, then it is known as adaptive maintenance. Adaptive, in simple terms, if we take an example that if there are some rules that must be that are given by some given by government agencies, then definitely in our software we have to incur these changes. So it is basically the adaptive maintenance, that we are adopting the changes according to the environment need. Next is perfective maintenance. Perfective maintenance is enhancement and scalability. We are trying to want that our software become the perfect, so we will use the perfective maintenance. And last, preventive maintenance. Definitely preventive means we are preventing our software being you can say that we are preventing, we are saving our we are securing our software so that it will not become the outdated. So it is known as preventive maintenance. In the next topic, we will elaborate these different types of maintenance. First is corrective maintenance. As we have already discussed in corrective maintenance, what we will do, we will try to remove the bugs. So as first is taking existing code. Definitely in maintenance will start after the software release. So definitely if there is corrective maintenance, then we will take the existing code and correcting a fault as causes the code to behave in some way. That it will be possible that we want that code should be behave in different way, but in the user side it is behaving in another way. Then in the case, the programmer will take the existing code and he or she will try to correct a fault. So it is known as corrective maintenance. Second is focus on bug fixing and reporting error fixing. The corrective maintenance mainly focus on bug fixing and reported error fixing. That is, when as and when the bug get fixed or when the error get removed, then we can say that the corrective maintenance is done. That is, defect generally need to be corrected either immediately or in the near future. If user or you can say the customer is using the software, and if there is any bug, then definitely this bug or error should be immediately solved. So corrective maintenance is very important. Fixing a fault has 20-50% chances of introducing another fault. So these things we should keep in mind, that programmer could change in one module, but he or she should also parallelly see that it is affecting to the other modules or not. So if it is affecting the other modules, then parallelly he should try to fixing a fault as soon as possible. So that was all about corrective maintenance. Next is adaptive maintenance. In adaptive maintenance, as I have already discussed, that in adaptive maintenance also we will start with taking existing cost and adapting it to provide new features and functionality. So these are typically part of new release of the code and part of a larger development code. As you all know that software companies or like Microsoft Office, or if you are using some software in your mobile phone, then as and when time passes, they release the new versions of the software. So if new versions are coming in the market, then definitely we have to change our software according to these new softwares, or we have to release the new version of our software. Okay, which is making changes in existing software to accommodate a changing environment. Definitely, if the market is changing, then we have to change our software too. Which is include all work related to how the software functions, that is related to enhancing software functionality. So, in adaptive maintenance, generally the programmer wants to enhancing the software functionality. If he or she is working in enhancing the software functionality, it will be possible and there is no error. But we are basically in adaptive maintenance, we are not fixing the bugs. What we are going to do is we are enhancing the software functionality, that is that software may or may not be already functional in the company. Next is prospective maintenance, implementing new or changed user need which concern functional enhancement to the software. Again, prospective maintenance is somehow related to adaptive maintenance works according to changing environment. And perfective maintenance works according to maybe it may be due to our own need, as we want that our software looks perfect, or it may be because the customer wants that their software should be perfect. So he or she may want to do some changes in their software. Okay, it includes all effort to improve the quality of the software in perfective maintenance. Basically, the programmer works for improving the quality of the software. It includes improving reliability and efficiency. So, if we incur these changes, or if we change our software record, or we want our software to be perfect, then definitely it will become more reliable and efficient. Okay, next is perfective maintenance. in perfective maintenance, sorry, preventive maintenance, what we will do in preventive maintenance, it includes anticipating future problems and to prove maintainability using techniques like documenting, commenting, or even re-implementing some part of documenting. So preventive maintenance, what we are going to do is basically, we want that our software should be preserved either with the help of documenting, re-implementing, re-documenting, or we can use, in this case, we can generally use re-engineering concept that we have already discussed, but what is re-engineering? And old system start as a specification for a new system. So this is basically the re-engineering in which we will start with the old system, and as we want that our system should be prevent in the market, so what we will do, we will start to become changes in the first phase of the software, and then we will do the concept like forward engineering and reverse engineering. So preventive maintenance also increases the system maintainability. So these were the different types of maintenance that are there in the maintenance phase of SDLC. What are these? First, we have already discussed the corrective maintenance, adaptive maintenance, perfective maintenance, and preventive maintenance. Okay, let's discuss the next topic. Again, as we have discussed, the SDLC maintenance was almost 67% of total cost of SDLC phase. If we talk about cost of maintenance, then perfective maintenance take 50% of total cost of maintenance, and corrective maintenance take 21%, and preventive maintenance take 4%, and adaptive maintenance 25%. So in this case, perfective maintenance take almost 50% of the total cost of maintenance. So the important topic is software maintenance models. First model is prefix model, like we have already discussed the software models in SDLC, in which we have discussed waterfall model, classical waterfall model, iterative model, spiral model, V model, so agile model. So these were the models that were used for the SDLC. Now we are going to discuss the software maintenance model. So let's start with first model, prefix model. Prefix model generally behave like the build and fix model of SDLC, in which what we will do, we will first of all, we will build the software, and if there are any changes, then we will make the changes, and again we will make the our software. So similarly in prefix model, like if any problem arise in the maintenance phase, then we problem, as and when problem found, then the programmer tries to fix it, and really change the software to the user, and again if any problem found, then again he will fix it. So this is basically the prefix model. This is basically an ad hoc approach in which we are waiting for the problem to be occurred, and as and when problem occur, it will get fixed. The user will, the programmer will fix it and release to the user. Changes are made at the code level as early as possible without anticipating future problem. It is not being done that we are running the program using all test cases. If problem found, then the programmer wants that as early as possible these changes will be done, then the software get released. As a result, the structure of software degrades rapidly. So if this process will continue, then as the time long, then structure of software degrades, and it is not suitable for large software system, like build and fix model was suitable for program having 100 or 1000 lines. Similarly, the prefix model is also not suitable for large software. It is generally used for maintaining the small software that is having the 2 or 3 programs. Second is iterative enhancement model. Iterative enhancement model, like in iterative enhancement model of SDLC, what we will do, we will make changes in one module, and we will develop one module and release the module. After that, we will create another module, and by joining, we will release that particular module. Similarly, in iterative enhancement model, incorporate changes in the software based on the analysis of the existing system. Assume complete documentation of the software is available in beginning. In iterative enhancement model, what we are assuming is that complete documentation is available with us, and it attempts to control complexity and try to maintain good design. The document of each software lifecycle, like SRS, design document, testing, etc. are also modified. So iterative enhancement model is also start with SRS, and in build and fix model we are not using any SR, not making changes in the SRS and design phase, but in iterative enhancement model we are starting with SRS, we are going to change in designing document, testing document, etc., and then we will make any changes to the software. So iterative enhancement model is more useful than the quick fix model. So these are the things that we are going to use in iterative enhancement model: redesign current and proposed implementing modification, and characterized version. So in this case, we will redesign the correct and proposed system, then we will implement the modification, then we will release our new version. Okay, based on the different types of perspective, the next model that is used is full reuse model. The reuse model based on the reuse of existing software component. Definitely, the reuse model, as the name suggests, reuse model will reuse the existing software component. It has four steps. Like first thing, in first step, identification of the parts of the old system that are that we can use in our next version of the software. So first part is we will identify the part of the old system that we are going to use in the new version of our software. Second is understanding the system part, that we will understand that when or how we can use the old system parts in our new system. Next is modification of the old system part appropriately to the new requirement. When we decided that these parts are okay and these parts require changes, then what we can do is this, that we will make the changes. We will keep a part of these parts that doesn't want any changes, but we will make changes to the old system parts appropriately to the new requirement in which the user wants the changes. And after that, integration of the modified part into the new system. So in simple terms, we can say that starting with the old system, we will identify those parts with the changes and keep a part of those parts that that doesn't need any changes. Then we will make the changes in the part that were not according to the new requirement. And after that, we will integrate the modified part into the new system. So in this case, we will able to create a new version of our software. So this was the next model of software maintenance. Like we can say that these are the component library. That component library is basically is the old system that we are going to take. In this, there are old system requirement and list of old system design, source code, test data. According to this, we will create the new system requirement analysis. As you can see that with the help, this is bi-directional. That means some requirement could be taken from the old system and some requirement could be taken from the outside environment. Similarly, in case of designing, some requirement could be taken from the old design version and some designing requirement could be taken from the outside environment. So similarly, the source code, we could take the old code also, and we could incorporate the new code also. So this is basically the full reuse model, and it is very important model that is used in the maintenance phase. So till now we have discussed three models. First was quick fix model, iterative enhancement model, and full reuse model. Now the next model that we are going to discuss, Bohan's model. Bohan was a person that made this model with the help of steps that we have already discussed. Bohan proposed a model for the maintenance process based upon the economic modeling principles. So the two things that Bohan keeps in mind was, Bohan model was the economic model, and it was based on some principles that must be followed when we want Bohan model was basically based on two things, that is economic. The Bohan model was economic model, and it is based on some principles. Bohan represent the maintenance process as a closed loop cycle. in which that means it works according to a cycle. Changes are proposed first, then changes are made. Like Bohme model starts with proposed changes. First of all, the thing proposed changes. What are the various changes that are required? It will come. These changes will be evaluated. It will not be there that the user proposed some changes and the programmer will start working. No, first of all, the proposed changes will come and these will get evaluated. After that, change these will be changes will be implemented and according to that, new version of software released. So, in this case, these Bohme model will work in the cycle. So, these two things keep in mind that Bohme model was based upon the economic models and the principles and it works in the cyclic manner. And it was developed by the Bohme. Last model of software maintenance, that is Todt maintenance model. Todt, this model was also also given by the Todt. So in this model, generally as we can say that in SDLC we are having the 7 phases. We can say the top maintenance model is having the 8 phases. First is change request phase. Second is estimate phase. First is change request phase. Change request phase. In the change request phase, the changes will come from the user. Then estimate phase. These changed requests will be estimated. After that, schedule will be prepared that how these changes should be done. Then the programming phase. In programming phase, these changes will get to be done. In test phase, these changes will be tested. Documentation phase, according to the changes, documents documentation will be done. And then when the documentation will be completed, the phase, the software will be released in the market and after that, it will become operational. So these are the 8 phases of top maintenance model. Okay, we can see this in specific question also, like change request, estimate, schedule, program, test, documentation, release, operation. And again, in a cyclic fashion, if any problem occurs, then again the change request will come. It will get estimated. We will make a schedule. And we will do the programming. Testing will be done. Then we will make the change in the documentation. New version will get released, and it will get operation, and so on. So this maintenance model will work like this. So it has the 8 phases. Okay, so that was all about the maintenance phase. So let me repeat all the topics in one go. First of all, what we have discussed, what is maintenance, what were the various maintenance problems that could be arise, types of software maintenance, that were corrective maintenance, adaptive, prospective and preventive. That should be keep in mind, it is very important topic. Corrective maintenance, adaptive, prospective, preventive maintenance. Then we have discussed software maintenance model, quick fix model, that is simpler model which is used not suitable for the large software. Then we have discussed the iterative enhancement model. Then full reuse model, then Bohme model, and please keep the eye on the diagram part. Then we will discuss the top maintenance model. It will have the 8 phases. Okay, hope all these topics are clear to you. In the next video, we will discuss our last unit, that is having the 2 topics, case tools and the configuration management system. Okay, for any query, you could mail me at savita.singh@ipmg.ac.in. Okay, thank you so much.